We are now starting with the blood groups. Now, when we say blood groups here, because we are talking of the blood group system in human beings, we are talking of ABO system. Now, let us first talk about a couple of scientists. The blood groups A, B and O were explained by Landsteiner, whereas blood group AB was explained by De Castello and Sturley. So this is how we have four blood groups, but the system is known as ABO. Let us take a couple of interesting things about it. Blood group is a type of inheritance which is known as multiple allelism. Multiple allelism. That means this trait is controlled by more than two alleles. In normal genetics or the Mendelian laws, we talk of two alleles responsible for a particular trait, or in other words, we say one gene has two forms, which are known as alleles. Here, there are three alleles. And these alleles, they are written as IA, IB, and IO. These are the alleles. Every individual would have only two out of these three. And out of these three, two are dominant and IO is recessive. So there are three alleles which control or are responsible for our blood groups. Now let us see what are the possible combinations an individual can have out of these three. As we said, every individual would have only two alleles, but the alleles controlling blood group are three. So let us see these combinations. It can be IA, IA. It can be IA, IO, that is homozygous and heterozygous. Then it can be IB, IB, and again heterozygous, IB and IO. Another combination is IA and IB. And next combination is both recessive. Now, when these combinations are there, what type of blood group would that person have? Here, both the alleles are having A, so the blood group is going to be A, but this is homozygous. In case of the second situation, it is going to be again A, but it is heterozygous. Here, it is the blood group is going to be B and homozygous, and in case of the fourth option, it's again going to be B and heterozygous. In this situation, it is going to be the blood group is going to be AB, and here there is no scope of hetero and homozygous because both the genes are dominant. So AB blood group is an example of codominance, where both the genes are dominant and they are expressing themselves. And IO, IO, it is all recessive. So this is blood group going to be O and this is again recessive. So both the genes, they are recessive. So now let us see how many genotypes are possible. Genotypes means the genetic makeup. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So there are 6 genetic types possible. So IA, IA, which we call homozygous, this is heterozygous, this is homozygous for B, heterozygous for B, this is IA, IB, both the genes are going to express and this is completely recessive. And now let us see the phenotypes. That means what kind of blood group these people will have. These two have blood group A. These two have blood group B. Then this is AB and this is O. So there are six genotypes and there are four types of blood group. Types of blood groups. And alleles, we have already seen that there are three alleles. So when we talk of blood group, it is decided by three alleles. So that is why it is an example of multiple alleles. Three alleles give us six genotypes and four types of blood groups. Now, what is that thing which is making our blood group A, B, AB or O? Those are the antigens. So let us take individual blood groups and see which type of antigen is present and antibody. Now let us take individual blood groups and see which type of antigen and antibody they have. So if a person has blood group A, then what is the situation? The genotype of this person could be homozygous, that is IAIA, or it can be heterozygous also. Both possibilities are there. Out of this, if this is the genetic makeup, that means both are dominant alleles. Here, one is dominant, one is recessive. And whenever there is a dominant allele, it will help in formation of a protein. So, on the RBC of this individual would be present a protein which is known as antigen A. And that is why the blood group is A. And in the plasma of the same person, this is the RBC, and this antigen is present on the surface of RBC. Whereas in plasma would be present an antibody. These antibodies are our natural defense in our immune system, which is capable of differentiating between self and non-self. This antigen becomes self. And so our body doesn't destroy this. But if some other antigen comes, like antigen B, then our body should be able to fight with it and destroy it. And that is why in the plasma are present antibodies. So here in this case, it is going to be antibody B. And to avoid confusion with the capital, we write antibody B. So, antigen is written as capital alphabet and antibody is written as a lowercase or small alphabet. So, now this is the case when the person has blood group A. What would happen if a person has blood group B? Second situation, blood group B. Genetic makeup again could be IB, IB if it is homozygous, IB and IO if it is heterozygous. And because of this, B on the RBC would be present antigen B, and in the plasma would have antibody B. Antibody B can also be written as anti-B. Anti-B. So this would be the situation in a person having blood group B. Third situation, blood group AB. Now, there is only one genotype which is possible, and the genotype is IA and IB. Both are dominant alleles. So, on the RBC, both these alleles would result in formation of proteins. So, there would be antigen A as well as antigen B. That means antigen A is also self and antigen B is also self. So there cannot be any antibody, because antigens and antibodies, they react. Let us take this situation. If a person has antigen B, antibody would be A here. Sorry, let us have this correction. Antibody A. Here antigen is A, antibody B. Here antigen is B. So antibody is going to be A. That means if by mistake, if this person receives blood group of A type, then what would enter is antigen A. And this antibody will destroy this. But in this situation, both the antigens are present. So A antigen is also self for this individual and B is also self. So there cannot be any antibody. So here there is no antibody. Neither A nor B. Last situation, that is blood group O. That is blood group O. Only one genotype is possible again here. It is going to be IO, IO, 100% recessive. Both the alleles are recessive. And as they're recessive, they do not result in formation of any protein. No transcription, no translation. So on the RBC, there is no antigen. So in this case, there is no antigen, neither A nor B. That means for this individual, A antigen is also going to be foreign and or non-self, and B antigen is also going to be non-self. So it should be able to defend itself if those foreign particles enter. And that is why in the plasma, both anti-A and B are present. Let us quickly go over it. What exactly is happening when we are saying four different types of blood groups? In a person having blood group A, there are two possible genotypes. It can be homozygous for A or heterozygous. Whenever there is a dominant allele, it results in formation of a protein by the process of transcription and translation. So that protein is an antigen. It is present on the surface of the RBC. So this protein becomes self for this individual. And natural defense is against any foreign antigen. So B would be foreign for this. So the body has prepared antibody B. In case if B blood group comes in, RBC with that B antigen, this antibody is going to fight with it. And that would be antigen-antibody reaction. In case of blood group B, also the situation is same. Two types of genotypes. And because of two dominant alleles or one, antigen B is produced. So this B becomes self, and what would be non-self is A. So it would have antibody A. In case of an individual with AB blood group, again one genotype is possible. But here, both the alleles are dominant. That means they undergo transcription and translation and both produce proteins. So on the surface, both antigens are present, antigen A as well as B. So if these two are present in an individual, they become their own and nothing becomes from outside. So no antibody. If antibody A is present, it will fight with or will react with A antigen. If antibody B is present, it would react with B. So to minimize that, there is no antibody here. In case of blood group O, which is a recessive blood group, both the alleles are recessive. And as the alleles are recessive, no transcription, no translation. So on the surface of RBC, there is no antigen. And in other words, we can say, as this individual is not having an antigen, antigen A or B, if they come from outside, they become foreign particles for this particular individual. And it should be able to defend itself. So it will have anti-A also, that is antibody A, as well as antibody B. Now, when we have understood this, we would be able to also understand which blood group can be given to the person of another blood group. So let us see how what happens when these blood transfusion or blood mixing or blood donations are done.